There are issues with the GSTN, there's no doubt about it. Part of these issues are transitional, part of it operational. And we always knew that this is not going to be a very smooth affair. It's a very large process that's been done. Yes, it's true that we have all states having problems. This will be discussed in the council today. And I would recommend that we set up a small group of ministers which will examine this in detail and work out a way forward in the next 2 to 3 months.
Will the September 10th deadline be extended for filing of returns, the GST?
I don't think so. I mean, I don't think there's need for that kind of thing yet.
But if there's an issue,
it's about your technological issue. It's about a technological issue, and it'll be redressed. It's not that it's not being redressed, and I don't think we either launched it ahead of time or whatever. This would have happened even if we had launched the GST in 1 year from now. So let's be very clear on those things. These have to be faced fair and square, and I would, as I said, would recommend that a small group of state ministers sits on this issue, spends a couple of days and works out a way forward of how to handle this.
So, you know, the government had said that states will be able to get a 14% revenue growth even post-GST implementation. How have things really looked at?
I think that's the biggest thing. This is the first GST meeting after the returns have been filed, and I think we're very happy, at least from where I stand. In J&K, nationally, the numbers look very good. And you must recognize the fact that these numbers come at a time when, first, you're in a transition to a new regime. Two is that the GDP growth has been very, very slow. So we are not talking of buoyancy of revenues here. We're talking really elasticity of revenues and the dispersal that it's increased. I don't think revenue concerns should now remain, because in the first thing itself, we have had a much higher revenue than was expected. Going forward, revenue should look much better.
So this means that Jammu and Kashmir will not bear any kind of a revenue loss
for the state of J&K would never bear a revenue loss. I mean, we're a consuming state, so we knew that right from the word go. So it was only about states that were producing states. I mean, Gujarat, Maharashtra had issues. J&K never had issues.
Mr. Drabu, on the issue of cess on SUV cars and luxury cars, a lot of car makers over the last 2 days have been raising this concern. What is the way forward? Can we expect the 10% hike to be done in one go, or is it going to be a staggered?
Look, the hike that was done earlier, which was approved, was an enabling hike. Now we look at the numbers, the mid-car segments and the others, and see whether it will need to go the full hog or perhaps in two stages.